The blame train chugs on. Hillary Clinton now says she wants the U.S. Electoral College system abolished after losing it. Hillary adding the Electoral College to the growing list of reasons why she lost. Look who's here to react to Hillary's blame tour, economist Ben Stein. Good to see you, Ben.
Good to see you. Thank you.
So when you lose, you change the very fabric of our U.S. voting system?
Change the Constitution. Change the Constitution to make it so that the Democrats will be sure to win next time. And if the Democrats should happen to not win that way, then they'll try to change it some other way. Look, the Constitution enshrined the Electoral College as a way of giving some equality and equivalence of power to sparsely populated states as compared with densely populated states. It is a vital part of our republic. It is not a joke, and it's not something to be toyed with because a woman ran a poor campaign,
yeah,
and even though she spent something like five times as much as her opponent, still lost.
Ben, tell me where I am wrong here. Just correct me on this. Am I wrong in saying that the Democrats are about the rights of minority interests, so shouldn't small states count here? And didn't Hillary get most of her popular vote in one state, California?
And she got a huge amount of it in California and a huge amount of it in New York. If you took out those two states, you would not have gotten a majority of the popular vote. No, look, the Democrats are in favor of minority votes as long as the minority votes are left-wing, progressive, anti-Republican votes. They're not in favor of minority votes if those votes are from rural areas or from suburban areas or from areas that do not necessarily hew to the progressive line and bow down and worship Hillary Clinton and bow down and worship Al Gore and the climate change people and the anti-gun people. I mean, she has a certain idea in her head, which is that everybody should bow down and worship me. I screwed up the campaign. I had tons and tons of money. I had the media on my back, I mean, on my side, backing me up all the way, and I still lost. It can't possibly be my fault.
Yeah.
It must be James Madison's fault for creating the Constitution.
Ben, remember when Hillary Clinton attacked President Trump, when candidate Trump, quote, threatened democracy. Well, basically, she's saying Trump threatened democracy by not promising to accept the election results. Let's take a listen.
That's horrifying. You know, every time Donald thinks things are not going in his direction, he claims whatever it is rigged against him. That is not the way our democracy works.
That is a direct threat to our democracy. I'm not going to try to call it anything else because that's what it is. All this talk about the election being rigged, trying to stir up people who are supporting him at his rallies, that is a direct threat to our democracy.
So it's bad when Trump does it, but okay when Hillary threatens democracy?
Well, I don't even understand what she's talking about. It's bad when a candidate tries to stir up his followers to vote for him. I mean, what was she doing the whole campaign but trying to stir up minority groups, especially to vote against Republicans and trying every trick she could to try to make the Republicans seem like racists without the Republicans showing the slightest sign of racism? I mean, talk about trying to whip up your constituents and your voters. Hillary did it as much as she possibly could without any basis in fact whatsoever. The whole Democratic campaign was based on this big lie that Trump was a sexist and a racist, and there's never been any evidence of it at all.
Yeah.
It's just completely made up. It's as if they said that Trump was from another planet.
And a smear of the Trump voter that they're racist. It was the biggest smear of all. I mean, that was an historic smear.
Yes, yes, deplorables.
Deplorables.
Deplorables because they believe in religion and they believe in the Second Amendment. Deplorable because they believe in God. I'd like to tell you, go ahead,
finish your thought.
I was going to say, I've seen this up close and personal in Hollywood, where there is a blacklisting of people who believe in God. That is a consistent fact of life in Hollywood. And I think Hillary and her friends would make it a consistent fact of life in America generally, that you would blacklist people who believe in God.
You know, calling people irredeemable when all the major religions of the world said everybody's redeemable. I mean, right, Ben? That was quite the contradiction.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She is a very tough person and an unforgiving person. And, you know, a little bit of humility would have gone a long way if she had said, I made mistake after mistake after mistake. I didn't go to visit Wisconsin one single time. That might have been gone
it's not
a little
on the
bit
list.
Farther.
And that's not on the list. Ben Stein, we love having you on. Thank you so much. We're going to wait and
God
watch
bless
to
you.
See
Thank
if
you so much.
Not going to Wisconsin makes that Hillary blameless.